What's up guys, I'm doing a skin giveaway every video. What you have to do to enter is like the video, subscribe to my channel, and as third, send your ID in the comments. The winners will be announced in the outro as you can see here in the bottom left. Good luck to everyone. Welcome to Mobile Legends Tutorial Episode 1 featuring Garry. In this tutorial you will learn how to play Garry perfectly and master her completely. Garry is one of the new marksmen and is definitely very strong. She can also kill tanks really fast with her ultimate because it does double the attack speed, and also with the items like the Demon Hunter Sword and the Windtalker you can destroy them very fast. There's also a pentakill as you could see in the video. So let's take a look at the summary. First we talk about the background, then we talk about the pros and cons, then some general info, then we discuss the abilities and how to use them, then we discuss the best build, then we discuss the matchups, who is Garry strong against and who weak against, and as last we finish off with a gameplay. So let's talk about the background of the new hero Garry. Garry lives in a strange humanoid race, it's called the Yasson. They are in human shape while they have a really rare strange feat. They have insane crazy techniques that allow them to create significant civilization and to invade others. Since Garry was a child, she was very talented and trained into an excellent and arrogant warrior leader. But also, at the same time, she lost her feelings and became a machine. After her escape from death, Garry didn't believe it, but she started to suspect it after her turning to her empire. For saving her empire, for redemption, Garry chose to believe and came to the Land of Dawn. What kind of destiny is waiting for her? So let's take a look at the pros and cons of the new hero Garry. The best thing about the new hero Garry is the insane attack speed you get with the ultimate. With these items they are in the game, like the Demon Hunter Sword and the Windtalker, she makes a very strong hero. A good thing about this new hero is also she has a dash. Dashing is really important to escape clutch situations. The new hero is also very good against tanks because of the ultimate also and the items. One good thing about her passive is it does true damage, so also it does maximum HP damage, so this is also good against tanks. The con of the new hero Garry is that when you do the first build, as I will show later, with the Demon Hunter Sword as first item, you are pretty weak because before you can buy the item you need like 1500 gold, and that's a huge gold gap between the items. Second con is that it's pretty hard to kite with the ultimate. Kiting means that you walk back and also keep auto attacking. Because of this high attack speed it will be difficult to hit a lot of attacks, auto attacks, and also walk back. So let's talk about the general info about the new hero Garry. So the main role of Garry is marksman. Marksman means you're a ranged hero that does a lot of damage, like almost the most damage in your team, and also only physical damage. The marksman is usually defended by a support like Estes or Raffaella or a tank that can defend this marksman. The marksman also almost always goes in the bottom lane because the red buff is in the bottom lane, which increases the physical attack. When you use Garry, be sure to position yourself in team fights in the far back so the enemy won't hit you and the tanks will tank all the damage. As a marksman it's important to not take a lot of damage and deal damage from far away because you're a ranged marksman. So let's take a look at the abilities of Garry. So for the passive, add a light wheel mark to the enemy at each basic attack or skill. When light wheel mark is added up to 5 marks at target, they will become the actual light wheel, piercing the target and dealing 7% to 13% true damage of maximum HP. Damage is up to 300 towards jungle monsters. When the passive is popped, you see an animation. So the first ability is called Spinning Light Wheel. It has an 8 second cooldown and a mana cost of 80. It releases flywheels that stop at target location, dealing 200 physical damage on the path and slowing them by 60%, dealing 100 physical damage to the enemies nearby, target location, and slowing them. Here you can see the animation of the first ability. It does continually see the damage when the enemy is close to the ability. This ability is mostly used for wave clearing or slowing the enemy while chasing. As you can see here, I slow the enemy so the Gord cannot escape. So we saw the second ability. It's called Phantom Step. The cooldown is 6 seconds and the mana cost is 50. It moves toward the direct selection while releasing a flywheel to the most nearby enemy, dealing 150 damage. It releases 2 flywheels when you use your ultimate. Here I use the second ability to dodge Gord's stun. You can mostly use it for dodging skills, escaping or chasing enemies. So the third ability is called Speedy Light Wheel, with a cooldown of 30 seconds and a mana cost of 140. It enters double lock mode in the next 6 seconds, increasing movement speed and releasing 2 light wheels at basic attack, while each basic attack deals 50% damage. With the items you buy in the build you will show next, this ability is one of the strongest abilities in the game and you will do a lot of damage. As you can see here, I kill the tank really fast with the ability and also the slider gets destroyed in a couple seconds. So let's take a look at the first build. So for the emblem sets, you want to use the jungle emblem sets because the statistics are better on the jungle emblem set. For the skill, you want to use Purify because you have a dash to escape so you don't need flicker, and Purify is the most safe way to go. For the first item, you always want to buy the jungle item, just a tier 1 jungle item, because you will be clearing the jungle a lot when you have no time to do other things. So for the first item, you have Demon Fallen Sword. This is the strongest item with this hero because it does percentage health damage, and because of the ultimate you do double attack speed and you do a lot of HP damage. So the second item, you want to buy boots just to escape and roam around the map very fast. For the third item, you want to buy Windtalker because this item does a lot of damage because as you looked at the passive, every fifth attack you do a lightning chain damage to 3 nearby enemies, which deal a lot of damage. So for the fourth item, you want to buy lifesteal just to sustain a lot, and the fifth and sixth item is just increasing your critical hit and physical attack to do even more damage. So for the second build, the emblems, the skills and the first item remain the same. Also the end build stays the same, only I changed the first and third item in order. Because with this build, you have early game is a lot stronger because you do more damage to squishy enemies like marksmen and mages, but your damage to the tanks will be lower. I think the second build will be stronger, but we have to test it out when she comes to the live service. So let's take a look at what heroes Garry is strong against. Garry is strong against pretty much every tank, but these heroes I showed here, they have no real mobility and they are easy killed by Garry. Garry is weak against these heroes because Karina is an assassin which can burst down this marksman really fast, and the first ability blocks all auto attacks. Clint is also strong against Garry because Clint's range is a lot bigger than Garry, and also his first ability, the smoke, makes Garry miss 30% of her basic attacks, which makes Clint stronger in 1v1s. Also Natalia can counter Garry really hard because she can silence Garry, and Natalia does the cloud which makes all basic attacks useless. So now you know all the basic info about Garry, let's take a look at the gameplay where I will be commentating and giving you tips and tricks to play Garry better. Be sure to also watch the gameplay because you will learn a lot of it. I hope you will enjoy the gameplay. So let's take a look at the gameplay. Some of you have already seen this gameplay, but I will be commentating now over it since I didn't do it the first time. So as you can see here, I buy the first jungle item because it's really really strong and you will be clearing the jungle a lot, so it's strong to have. Also, I'm playing alone on the advanced server, so normally I would go bottom lane, but since there also is a marksman at the bottom lane with a support, I cannot do that, so I just go top lane with Nana. Nana's also a support, so going top lane is not that bad, and with getting the blue makes you spam your abilities a lot. First ability spam is pretty good because you can do a lot of poke to the enemy in lane. So here I can see Nana is already dying at level 1, which happens, it doesn't really matter. So I use my first ability to clear the wave, And I see this Fanny is low, taking another tower shot, so I dash and dodge the cord stun, which is a very good usage of the dash. And now I can see, you can see I kill the cord as well, getting a double kill with almost full HP because I dodged all the abilities. So I use my first ability again, just to wave clear. I have blue buff, so the mana costs are really, really low because the blue buff cuts the mana cost. I think it's in half, but I don't really know. So I see Fanny going back to lane. I'm just clearing the jungle because I have the jungle item. I clear the jungle faster and get a lot of XP from it. Fanny is actually going in, so I dash. I didn't dash in. I used my first ability, but I missed it because she ran away. She's not really escaping, so I'm just dealing damage. I dash in, and the dash kills the enemy. So here I fight Gord. He stuns me because my dash was not up to dodge it. Use my dash, but I dash into the wall, but Gord also dies because he's getting slowed. So we have 4 kills already at not even 2 minutes. So I see here, Minotaur is pushed in the middle lane, so I go to the middle lane to kill them. It's very good to pay attention to your minimap so you can get kills. Like, now this is a free kill to have because I watched at the minimap. So I look at the minimap again, and when clearing the wave, I see Fanny is pushing, and Nana's almost dead, but also this Fanny is almost dead. So I decide to go top lane again. Also Moskov is incoming, I don't know why, he should stay bottom actually. But I see this Fanny really low, so I walk in the bush, flank her. She's not doing the jungle, I think she is in the bush. So I check the bush, but I saw her in the right corner of my screen, running away. So this corner is really close to me, and as you can see, I do some nice damage. And yeah, he can't escape because Moskov is at the other side of the tower, which makes it a free kill. So here I just proxy farm, it's called proxy farming, meaning you kill the minions between the two towers, so your minion wave will immediately crash into the tower, and yeah, I can zone them off so they don't take the minion XP and gold. So I got my first item, which I will do a lot of damage now. Look, I do the 2 auto attacks and it's almost half HP. So I dash in again, I really want to kill him. It's because I know he's not that smart and he will go back to the tower to get the minions, as you can see in the minimap. He is losing a lot of XP and gold, so he decides to actually greed and try to get the minions, but I kill him and punish him for the mistake. Also, I can see I used Inspire this game, I was just trying, and also on Advanced server I don't have Purify unlocked yet, so my only option was to use Inspire. But it's also good, but it's really risky and yeah, you shouldn't do that in high ranked games. So my mana is low, I want to get the blue buff to regenerate some mana by killing it. And since I'm a marksman, I can clear the jungle really fast. Also, I have a lot of kills already, so I do damage. This Minotaur is pushing again, so again I look at the minimap and I know he's low, but I didn't manage to kill him because I think he saw me coming. So I see Fanny and Gord in the top lane again. Since they have no tower, they are pushing really far, and I'm really sure I can 1v2 them. So as you can see, I'm going top lane, trying to kill them. They are almost full HP, Gord is pretty low. So he misses his stun, this means that he is going to die. Fanny runs away with the rope. I'm low HP, so I think she thinks she can kill me, but my damage is just too big because I had 10 kills, and now I got 11 because Fanny died. So of course I use my heal because I'm low HP, that's normal. But, because I'm low HP, I'm also killing this crab. This crab gives a lot of HP and you can kill it really fast, so it's free HP. So again, what I do is just walk around, monk walk around the map, just clearing waves above, looking at the minimap, helping others out. I'm not really going bot lane because you can't go everywhere, that's not time efficient. So I want to help the Moskov here, but he died by the Gord. I killed the Gord, and also this Fanny has no chance to run away because my damage is just too big at the moment. So yeah, I just clear the waves again because I want to take the towers. But in this gameplay I just wanted to get a lot of kills, I didn't really care about pushing. But normally you should get the tower if you want to go for the win, because there's no one to kill you. Also this Lila is pushing, and I didn't use my ultimate because I didn't need to, and Lila dies really fast. Also, I'm just poking this Bane, not really looking to kill him, but he's pushing so far to me that I can kill him. And I stay in the corner here to dodge the ultimate of Bane so I don't take damage. see, Gord's coming now. I wanted to use my dash, but I was too late. But yeah, I can still manage to kill Gord. So I take the blue buff again, because my blue buff is not existing anymore. And yeah, I get some mana back, so I don't have to back to base and don't have to waste time. So let's see, I see Fanny at the top lane again, because I'm looking at the minimap always. So I get the kill still here, sorry Moskov, but yeah, I didn't see Hit's HP was that low. I know she was low, but not a one out attack low. So our Alice is pushing against the Gord. I want to flank from the other tower, and I managed to kill the Gord. Fanny is also going top lane again, and she's pretty scared of me already, but now she goes in and look at this damage, guys. It's insane. I'm so fat, they can't defend me anymore. And again, I kill the mains between the towers. So, Gord is also coming, but he can't even run. He's slowed, he can't do anything. He has no time to escape. Before he can react, he dies. So that's the power of the new hero carry. So I see three people on the bot lane. So this first time I actually help bot lane out, because there are a lot of people bot lane, so it's free to help. And our lanes are pushed. So I killed Lila and killed the Bane. And also Fanny is coming. So yeah, she wants to go in, but look at the damage. It's just 1 second and she's just dead. So I go bot lane because our lanes were pushing. So there was no farm to do. It was no farming. I just could do what I wanted to do. So I'm looking at the items, what I want to buy. I don't know what to buy here. Okay, I want to buy the critical hit item. That's useful, yeah. So as you can see here, and as you've seen the video before, I killed Smarter really fast, and Lila also dies in just one second, which makes me at 25 kills. And yeah, after this, the enemies concede it, because they know they have no chance, because I just kill them in 1 second, every one of them. Yeah, that was a really, really overpowered game. I got fat fast, and then it's just no stopping of this new hero. We get 25 kills, 0 deaths, 0 assists. I actually got 25 kills out of the 27 kills in total, which is really insane. As you can see in my gold, I tripled my teammate's gold, and I also do 48% damage of the team. Anyway, guys, if you think this guide was useful, be sure to drop a like, comment down below what you think of it, subscribe to my channel to see more guides, and I'll see you next time. See you later.